Hello and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we are not going to create some end product. What we're going to do today is to learn more about Illustrator and all the amazing things you can do with Illustrator. So today's topic is going to be Illustrator scripts. So let's get started. I'll just open a new file, go to File and New. Let's make 8 into 11 inches. You don't have to bother about these things, but let's make it RGB. Okay, so what are Adobe scripts? Adobe scripts are scripts written in either AppleScript or JavaScript, which help run things without you having to click buttons. It's not actions, to be precise. This one involves some code, which is written, and then you just have to run it, and then automatically things get done. So we can use Adobe scripts to quicken our workflow, and I'm going to show you today how to install them, or rather use them, because I'm not going to be installing them on my system, and where to find them. So the first things first, where do we find these scripts? So I'll leave a series of links down in the description where you can go ahead and find these scripts. Most of these are free. And there are some scripts which you can pay for, but we're not going to be covering those things here because, you know, we all love free stuff. So I have a set of scripts which I'm using right now in this tutorial. And I've downloaded them from this particular website. Don't worry, I'll leave the links below in the description box. So there'll always be a download button somewhere. So just download this onto your system. So there are two ways in which you can use these scripts. One is to install them on your system. Two is to not install them and just navigate to that folder whenever you want to use it. So basically here, if you go to File and then Scripts, you can see that there are some scripts which are already in Illustrator. And then if you click on other scripts, this is how you get to your scripts. So once you download the scripts by clicking on the download button, and if it's a zip file, make sure you unzip it, please. So once you unzip it and save it to a particular location, for example, I have mine saved here. This is unzipped and this is what I got from that website. Okay, and now it's time to go ahead and see how we can use it. Let's start with one of the example scripts, because I'm just gonna make some boxes right here. Okay, so we have some bricks here and we're gonna try and color these bricks. So the main thing we want is we want each brick to be of a different color, and you can always set the palette that you want. So I'm just going to go to my swatches right here. If you cannot see swatches, you can go to Window and then Swatches. Now I'm try and add some colors to my swatches from my library. So what you can do is you can just go to your library. I'm sure you'll have some colors saved here. If you don't have these colors, it's totally fine. What you can do is you can select these colors as well. I'm just going to select the palette right here and right click and say add to swatches. So it's going to add it here. So I'll do the same for a couple of more here. Something which I think, because we need a lot of colors for this. Let's put these. Okay, so we have all these colors ready now. So we'll select everything, switch this to fill color. Now we'll go to our swatches again, click, hold your shift key down and select all the colors. Now make sure everything is selected here, everything is selected here. Now go to File, Scripts, Other Script. Now navigate to the folder where you have saved all these scripts. And then I have my one of my scripts that's Randomizer right here. Just gonna click on that, click Open. And it automatically selects color based on these swatches and assigns a color to all the bricks. So this makes life so much easier when you want to know what your color palette is gonna be and how you wanna randomly assign it to things. So if you just select this again and then select all the colors again and go to File, Scripts and Other Script and click on Randomizer and press Open, it'll again assign a random color palette to that. So okay, so this is one of the scripts that I use most of the time because I think this is really nice. And then if you want to change some individual colors because you think there's quite an overlap, you can just go ahead and change it to whatever you want, something like this. So moving ahead, our next script is something very similar and has to do with colors. And for this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one of these bricks. Let's choose this one, make a copy of it, click and drag with your hook option or alt key down. I'm gonna click on this, go to File, Scripts, and other script. And this one was in the file that I downloaded from that website I showed you earlier. It's called AddSwatchesLightAndShadow. So I'm going to click on that and click on open. And next it will give you the RGB color, which is nothing but the color in this. And click OK. Make sure you are taking a look here. Just keep an eye out on this section right here and click OK. And you will see three different swatches right here. What it's doing is it's creating a lighter version and a darker version of it. So it's like, it's so amazing when you know you have a color and you want to create a lighter and a darker version. This is like the best script ever for that. So if I go back here and select everything and then click and select these three, go here. There you go. Okay, so next one is I want to show you something else. I'm going to make some boxes right here. Let's make this darker and something like this. Pink. Okay. Now I'm going to select everything and go to scripts, other script, and round any corner, click open. And you can give in your unit here. I'm just going to click okay. It automatically rounds every corner. If you forgot and used a rectangle tool instead of rounded rectangle tool, and you don't want to go back in and select on each things and make it rounded, this is one of the things you could do. So yeah, this is basically how you can use Adobe scripts or Illustrator scripts to make your life much easier. Like I said, I'm gonna leave the links below to all the scripts that I used and some websites where you can download them. And if you don't know how to get colors here in your library, do check out my video on Adobe Library. I'll try to link it in the description box below so that you know how to get it here. And this makes life much, much, much easier. I hope you enjoyed this really short tutorial on Adobe scripts. And if you have any questions, do leave a comment below and I'll try to answer them as soon as I can. So I guess until next week, bye-bye.